This is Mission Control Houston. Welcome to today's ISS update for Friday, February 17th, 2012. This is a live view inside the International Space Station's flight control room here at the Johnson Space Center. This team here is being led today by Flight Director Mike Serafin, who is there in the middle. Sitting beside him is Tony Sicacci, a former fellow shuttle flight director. He is also sitting on console, getting trained on the space station and its systems. Sitting beside them both as the Capcom today is astronaut Shell Lindgren. He is the voice of the team here in Houston to the Expedition 30 crew aboard the International Space Station. There's a look at the crew. The crew has a very busy Friday on tap for them. Don Pettit, who's on the far right, has been working on an experiment called SLICE. This stands for the Structure and Liftoff in Combustion Experiment. What it does is take a look at how different flames perform in space. There is a phenomenon called liftoff, which is where the flame actually comes up off the burner. And this is caused by a series of different things, whether it's the combustion elements themselves, what makes up the flame, or the different type of flow that is happening. Obviously, flames behave a bit differently up in space than they do here on the ground. But by studying this liftoff phenomena, as we talked about, it is hoped that teams here on the ground can design better products that have better fuel efficiency or better combustion inside of them. Pettit is also working today on some routine maintenance on the robotic workstation that is down in the cupola. This is sort of the Windows on the World module of the International Space Station. There is a robotics workstation there that is used anytime the crew is operating this station's robotic arm. So he will take care of that later on this afternoon. Meanwhile, Anatoly Ivanishin, another member of Expedition 30, is working on opening the transfer hatch between the pier's docking compartment, which is the site of yesterday's spacewalk, and the Progress 46 cargo craft. Those hatches were closed, obviously, because the cosmonauts were opening up the hatch on piers and decompressing it so they could step outside. So they had to seal off that Progress cargo craft, which you see the layout of the station there, docked back there with piers. So they will take care of opening that hatch back up later on today. Andre Kuipers is working on an experiment called MARS. This is the Muscle Atrophy Research and Exercise System. It's sort of an exercise system that it looks like something you would find on the ground here in a gym, but operates a little bit differently. This item measures and exercises seven different joints to see what happens to the crew members' bodies as they live up on board the International Space Station for up to 6 months. Monitoring the body's performance and how it adapts to space is incredibly important and one of the main things that the International Space Station is teaching us. Obviously, those lessons will be very important as humans venture beyond low Earth orbit and head to even further destinations out in space. Kuiper is also working on the cabin fan assemblies and ventilation ducts there inside the Columbus module later on this afternoon. Oleg Kononenko and Anton Chikaplerov are taking care of quite a number of different activities today and also recovering from yesterday's spacewalk. That spacewalk lasted 6 hours and 15 minutes. They'll be talking with ground controllers today to review yesterday's spacewalk and talk about everything that was accomplished. During that spacewalk, they completed the move of the Strela boom. This is one of the two large extension booms that are on the outside of the Russian segment of the station. They use these to move around and to gain access to different portions of the Russian segment. Strela 1 used to be on the piers docking compartment, which is on the bottom side of the station, the Earth-facing side of that part of the complex. They moved it up to the Poisk module, which is directly up above piers on the space-facing side of the Russian segment. There is another boom called Strela 2 that is still down on Poisk. That will be moved down on piers, excuse me. That will be moved later on this summer by a future crew. These Strela booms that you see the crew moving yesterday are being moved up to the top of the station to make way for the departure of piers. That particular portion of the station has been up there for more than 10 years, and it will say goodbye as it makes way for a brand new multipurpose laboratory module that our Russian counterparts will be launching later on next year. Dan Burbank, the commander of Expedition 30, is working on quite a number of different experiments today, including MELFI. This is the minus 80 laboratory. This is a large freezer on board the station that is used to store different types of samples and experiments at really, really cold temperatures. You're seeing a picture of it here. He is basically going to be doing a nitrogen pressure check just to make sure that MELFI is operating as expected. He is also going to be working on an experiment called BCAT-6. This is the binary colloidal alloy test. And he and the rest of the crew members also have several different crew Earth observation opportunities today. They will be flying directly above Chile, and we'll have a chance to take a look down at the Woolia Cove. This is an HMS Beagle landing site. And they will also be flying over the St. Helena Island, which is off in the Atlantic Ocean, off the coast of Africa. Of course, for all the latest over the weekend on the Expedition 30 crew, you can just log on to the NASA website at www.nasa.gov/station.